wasn't for a stand or anything like that, but I couldn't move, and I had my wheelchair. So I was back to the prison hospital in my wheelchair, and I suppose met a lot of fellas, and they were, some of them were divided, and Felix thought the members that I turned them and called it up, and I agreed that I turned them and called it up. So the others all agreed that it should have been called up. Me and McQueen said it shouldn't have been called up. Anyway, what we were told was that Brendan Tunes had been talking to NIO people, and they had an 18-page document. So they said we could work from there as a start. And they agreed, okay, we'll work from there. It's all about to start. The hundreds like it, and nobody had died talking about it. So we went to moved all our fellas back, quicker than moved me back. And I was in hospital, and Bobby Haven was looking after me well. And eventually I was there on my own. And it was okay, watching TV, reading papers, and reading all the book and whatnot. My eyes were pretty bad, but I could read if I held it very close and had a book under the tape. And down one line at a time. The reading wasn't very good, now it was very slow. It took maybe 20 minutes to get through a paragraph. But I suppose I was making progress. And they were giving us injections of vitamin and whatnot. And it was okay. So the vitamin injections were very sore. And we got them every morning, so I was on them for a long time. But to try and sort my eyes out and whatnot. So eventually I got out of the wheelchair. And I didn't like the wheelchair. The wheelchair was an awful good feeling, getting wheeled about everything. But I got out of the wheelchair anyway. And one day I was in bed, and they said that the doctor's coming in to see me. So this guy came in, and it was the guy with the grey hair that I had seen the time I died in the riot. So I told him about it, and he said, no problem. He says it was after death or a near-death experience. He says it's nothing to be afraid of.